Good morning, this is Cecily Tippery, and we're going to be talking about how to run a board meeting. First thing, I call this meeting to order. Today we're going to talk about, and this is on our agenda, we're going to talk about the purpose of a board meeting, we're going to discuss the general protocol and procedures, what to do in advance of a meeting, and what to do during a meeting. So, jam-packed information. First thing, what is the purpose? The purpose of a board meeting is to gather information. We want to review actuals to goals and make sure we're on track for our whatever we want to accomplish. So it's kind of a checkup on all the systems that you have in place. And third, you're going to decide on any action that provides guidance or makes adjustments to your project teams. So the purpose of a meeting is really just to check in and make sure that everyone's on track. Second on the agenda, who is on the board? In the new network model, there are 5 people on the board. There's a president, president-elect, secretary or treasurer, membership chair, membership director, or program chair. So there's 5 people on the board. How many does it take to make a quorum? And the answer is 3. Okay, you have to have 3 people there, one of which has to be the president or the president-elect. As this is a small group, we want to make sure that we reach consensus. You don't necessarily have to follow Robert's Rules of Order and take a vote on everything. What you want to do is reach a consensus. If you feel you need to take a vote, that's when the quorum comes in, but you just want to discuss items and make sure you're all going down the same path. So you don't need to vote on every single thing. Now, how many board meetings a year? There are required 4. We suggest this first year that maybe you have even 6 or 8, because this is the first year. You want to keep yourself on track. You want to keep the conversation going. So have as many as you think you need, but only if you need to have a meeting. Again, remember going back to the purpose, you want to help make decisions and keep people moving forward. So number 3 on our agenda today is what to do in advance of your meeting. Be prepared. That's pretty much it. Remember when you were Boy Scout or a Girl Scout? Be prepared. So how do you be prepared? The chair makes sure that everyone at that meeting has the following, and I'm going to read these just so you know, has the previous meeting minutes. It's very important that you know what happened so you have some sort of history. Secondly, you want to look at your most up-to-date profit and loss, your budget, your actual to your budget. Third, any program reporting forms that are provided at the network meetings should be, we think, given to everybody so that the whole board sees how we're doing with our programs. You could add some formal reporting for orientations and mixers and stuff like that. That's really up to you. But you want to at least look at what's happening at your programs. That program evaluation form that is provided by National. You also want to review your updated membership reports, including a national affiliate percentage, how many members you have at any given time, updated strategic partner list, that could change between meetings, and reports of minutes or project teams that are not assigned to your membership director or your program director. You want to make sure that your project teams are providing action items, minutes, things that they think they need to do to tell other people about so they can do a better job. So be prepared as a program director, membership director, or as head of a project team to make recommendations to the board as to what is necessary to keep moving forward, again, toward whatever goal that they have. Finally, now you're actually at the board meeting. After all this stuff, you're ready to go to the board meeting. So, as chair, very simple, first thing you do is I call this meeting to order, just as we started this presentation. Second, you note if there's a quorum present. So again, we talked about you have to have 3 of the 5. Number 3, you report, you have the minutes, and you make corrections if you need to, and you file them. If you're spending time at your board meeting reading minutes or going over financials, which is number 4, you want to make sure that you're spending time on the things that are important, which is programs and membership. Number 5 might be independent project teams, if you have independent project teams. Again, depends how your network is structured, because you might have ways and means or standing rules or, say, orientation or strategic partners, you might have a project team just separate for that that might report to either the president or the president-elect. Number six would be the project director report. That is the membership director report. So normally we would ask that the membership director report on the number of members to goal. If your goal is 80 and you're at 75, yay, but you have to know where you are at any given time. Number two, number of members that have, and their names perhaps, of who's joined since the last governing board meeting. The status of the project teams that report directly to the membership director. The membership director would have all that information, and then the membership director would make some recommendation as to how we're doing. Do we need to expand our project teams? How are the project teams that we have, how are they doing? And is it accomplishing what we want to accomplish? The program director is a little bit different in that they're going to just report on the programs that have been completed, but they're also going to talk about the marketing plan success, and they're going to talk about what they have future planned. Now that could, again, bring in the project teams, but they're going to make recommendations as to how to get those dynamic programs out there for the members that create value for the membership. That's what it's all about, creating value. I cannot stress it enough that you have to be aware of what's happening in the room. As chair or a member of the meeting, you need to make sure everyone has a voice. That's what the chair does. The chair doesn't necessarily talk. I know that's hard to believe. The chair listens. So when the chair's doing their presentation or asking for a report, you look around the table, you look around the room, you look for buy-in. Who's not agreeing, who's disagreeing, and if they don't speak up, you ask them, do you have something to say on this? So you make sure that everyone has a voice. You want to be inclusive. We're all in this together. Okay, to sum it all up, we talked about purpose, why you're having a meeting, you want to make sure everybody's on track. Number two, you want to follow the protocol during the meeting, reach consensus on your current activity and future action items. Number three, you need to be prepared on all levels for this as a chair and as a member of the governing board. And number four, during the governing board, you want to make sure that you're concentrating on what's best for the chapter to add value to your network members. So thank you so much. And this meeting is adjourned.